This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, use case template. Fourth one is use case template. If you want to prepare the use case document, we need four things. One is screenshot, second one is FRS, third one is special requirements. Special requirements and use case template. Okay, how use case template will be. So today, first concept to use case template. Okay. Use case template. Use case template. Different companies, they will maintain different use case templates. But max all the companies, they will maintain this template, use case template. Name of the use case. Login use case. Brief description of use case. Okay. What is the brief description of use case? It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. Brief description of use case. So that means it will describe the all the functionalities in the application. It will describe all functionalities in the application. Okay. It will escape the all the functionalities in the application. Okay, next requirements. There are two types of requirements. One is explicit, second one is implicit. One is explicit. Second one is implicit.
Daddy!
There are two types of requirements. One is implicit, second one is explicit. Implicit requirements given by explicit requirement given by customer or FRS, and implicit requirements given by business analyst. Okay. Actors. There are two actors. One is normal, second one is admin. Just concentrate, sir. Just concentrate. I will ask you questions. Just wait. Actors. There are two types of actors. One is normal, second one is admin. If it is normal user, if he enter username and password, it will open home page or admin home page. Okay. If it is admin user, if he enter admin username and password, it will go to admin page. Okay. There are two types of users. If it is any application, there are two types of users. Normal user, admin user. Okay. Next, preconditions. Preconditions. Okay. If he enter right username password, write username and password. It will go to home or admin page. If we enter correct username, correct password, if we click on login button, so if we enter right username, right password, if we click on login button, home or admin page must be displayed. Home or admin page must be displayed. If we enter wrong username, wrong password, if we enter wrong username, wrong password, corresponding error message must be displayed. If we enter correct username, correct password, so home or admin page must be displayed. If we enter wrong username, wrong password, so corresponding message must be displayed. That is the preconditions, post conditions. Error message. Post conditions is error message. If you enter wrong username, wrong password, it will display the error message. Error message. Flow of events. Normal flow. Action. Response. I will tell you action, you should tell the response. That is the concept.
Okay.
Action I will tell you, sir. You should tell the response.
Okay.
I will tell the action, you should tell the response. Actor invoke the application. What will happen? Actor means user. User invoke the application. What is the response?
We have to enter username and password and press login.
No. Actor invokes the application. What will happen? Response, what will come? If you click on that application, what will come? What will come? What you can get? Actor means user, invoke the application. So he is opening the application. What will happen?
Oh, it's open. Okay, it will go to homepage.
Whenever you invoke the login application should contain username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. You should tell like that. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Next, second requirement, I am asking, initial position of the cursor
should be at username.
Yes, that cursor should be placed in the username field. Okay. Actor click on login button, what will happen?
It has to go to home page.
No.
Okay, so user has to enter username and password and press login, then it will go to home page.
Actor enter username and password, if we click on login button, what will happen?
The application will go to the home page.
No.
No. Okay.
Actor enter valid username and valid password, and if we click on login button, what will happen? Actor enter username and password, if we click on login button, what will happen? User enter valid username, valid password, if we click on login button, what will happen?
It'll go to the home page, Akhil.
No. Actor enter valid username, valid password, if we click on login button, what will happen? Corresponding page must be displayed.
Oh, okay.
If it is normal user, home page, if it is admin user, admin page must be displayed.
Oh, okay.
Okay, compulsory, you should remember that point. So your requirement is it's not very easy, sir. So you need to concentrate each and every point. You need to study and you need to understand every point. Very, 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 very important. Okay. Ah, okay. I will ask you. Actor enter a valid username, invalid password, if you click on login button.
The error message will be displayed.
Error message must be displayed. Okay, right. Actor enter as invalid username, invalid password, if you click on login button.
Error message will be displayed again.
Okay, right. Actor enter only username, e-checking, enabled property of login button. He is entering only username, right or wrong, leave it. Okay. He is entering only username. He is checking enabled property of login button. Login button must be enabled or disabled.
It'll be enabled.
Actor enter only username, sir.
Oh, okay, okay. Sorry, disabled.
That application, that button, login button must be disabled.
Disabled.
Why? Because after entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. So here he is giving only username. He is not giving any password. Just that login button must be disabled. Okay. After enter password, he checking enabled property of login button.
It will be disabled.
Disabled. Why? Because after entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. Okay. After entering wrong username, wrong password, if we click on login button. Sorry. After entering username and password, wrong username or wrong password or right username or right password, whatever it is. The status of the clear button.
It's enabled all the time.
Why?
If you enter username and password, then it'll enable clear.
After entering username and password, that clear button must be enabled.
Enable.
After entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. So you are giving right username or wrong username, leave it. So after entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. Okay, next. I am using right username, wrong password. Already over, I think. Okay. Tabbing order of the application. Tabbing order of the application.
Username, password, login, clear, cancel.
Username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons you should mention.
Okay.
Okay. Compulsory, you should mention. you should mention types also. That is also very, very important. Okay. Next. Actor, click on clear button.
All the fields will be cleared and the cursor will be placed under username.
Yes, shabash. Okay. After click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. So, this is the use cases. These are the use cases. So, business analyst, you will add extra. FRS customer will give you. So, use case document prepared by business analyst. You will add the extra points, what we need to do, what will happen. That means, what is the response coming? Everything you will mention in the use case document. After getting the use case document only, we can understand the requirements very clearly. Without use case document, we can't understand the requirements very clearly. Okay? Use case document. Use case document prepared by business analyst. Based on the FRS only, you will prepare the use case document.
Okay.
Right. Over, sir. Use cases over. Next concept, test cases. Next concept, test cases. Very, very important, sir. Test cases concept is very, very important. Test cases. What do you mean by test case? Test case is nothing but it is an idea of testing unit. It is an idea of testing unit. Test case is nothing but it is an idea of testing unit. Very, very important concepts are test cases concept. So, just this is our first task, sir. So, up to now, we didn't discuss anything. We didn't discuss. So, this is the first concept. We need to write the test cases. So, test case. What is test case? Test case is nothing but it is an idea of test engineer.
Okay.
There are two types. There are two types. One is UI test case. Second one is functional test cases. One is UI. Already I told you, sir, GUI test cases already we discussed. If you want to perform GUI testing without perform any actions on the application, we can test the application. Then the type of test. Then the type of testing is known as GUI testing, already I told you. So if you want to perform GUI testing, what are the guidelines? GUI testing, graphical user interface. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as GUI testing, already I told you, or static testing. GUI or static. What is that? What are the guidelines? If you want to perform static testing or GUI testing, what are the guidelines?
It's without, like, we won't perform any actions. We can test it by looking at it, like the by the color or the availability, spelling,
color, okay,
grammar, alignment.
Next.
Or consistency,
availability,
so by looking at the application we can do some testing.
Consistency, consistency, alignment.
Mm-hmm.
color alignment, spelling align, consistency. Oh, two times I wrote. Color availability, consistency. Color alignment, consistency, spelling. Alignment. If it is any application, minimum we should write 5 test cases for any application. Without performing any actions on the application, we can write the test cases. Then the type of test cases is known as GUI test cases or static test cases. Compulsory. If it is any application, minimum we should write 5 test cases for any application. Next, functional test cases. Functional test cases. Functional test cases further divided into two parts. One is positive. Second one is negative. Functional test cases further divided into two types. One is positive test cases. Second one is negative test cases. So, for example, what is positive test cases? What is negative test cases? I will tell you. So, functional test cases means compulsory. We need to perform some actions on the functionality. Then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of test cases is known as functional test cases. We have one username field. Customer is saying that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. If you take in between 4 to 12 characters and if you do testing, that is called positive testing. If you do in between 4 to 12 characters, customer is saying that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. If you take in between 4 to 12 characters and if you do testing, that is called positive testing. Other than 4 to 12, like 13 or 3, 13, comma 3 or 14, if you take this type of inputs, that is called negative testing. If you take invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing. A test engineer should have negative mindset up. Then only he will become a good test engineer. So, here, customer is said that the username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. If you take in between 4 to 12 characters, like 5 characters, 6 characters, 7 characters, 8 characters, 9 characters, 10 characters, 11 characters or 12 characters. If you take, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. Other than 4 to 12, like you are taking 13 characters, 3 characters or 15 characters or 14 characters. These are the invalid inputs. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing.
Okay.
Next. Test case template. Test case template. What are the fields we have in test case template? Just concentrate, sir. Test case ID, TCID. TCID means test case ID. TC type, test case type. Test case description. Expected value.
No open, okay? Don't open it.
actual value. Results. Okay, test case ID, test case type, test case description, expected value, actual value and result. Okay, right. Test case ID. Different companies, they will write different names, sir. Some companies, they are writing TC001. Some companies, they are writing 001. Some companies, they are writing different companies, they will write different names, sir. So, test case ID, like I am writing 001, TC001. Test case type, for example, I am writing positive test case. No, GUI. Test case description, initial position of the cursor, initial position of the initial position of the cursor, expected value, what is the customer expecting? Initial position of the, what is customer expecting? Initially the cursor should be placed in the username field, UN field. So up to now we will write, okay. Up to now we will write, after getting the application from development department, whatever we are getting, we will write in the actual column, actual value column, whatever we are getting. So actually whatever we are getting, we will write in the actual value column, like so initial position of the cursor. So customer is said that cursor should be placed in the username field. After getting the application, we will observe and we will write username field, UN field. That cursor should be placed in the username field. So expected value, actual value, both are same. Expected value is nothing but customer requirement, sir. Expected value is nothing but it is a customer requirement. Actual value is nothing but it is a. So whatever we are getting, we will write in the actual value column. Whatever actual value. Whatever we are getting, whatever we are getting, we will write in the actual value column. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. If it is both are same, we can give the status pass. Otherwise, we can give the status fail. That is the test case template.
Okay.
So, expected value, nothing but it is a customer requirement. Actual value is nothing but whatever we are getting, we will write in the actual value column. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. If it is both are same, we can give the status pass. Otherwise, we can give the status fail.
Oh.
Right.
This conference will now be recorded.
First test case. See. Check for the initial position of the cursor. Check for the availability of all the object as for the login object to tab. So, for example, sir, we have taken only one application, that is the login application. Login application having only 6 fields, sir. Username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel buttons. Okay, only 6 buttons. Only if you have only 6 buttons, you can mention. But if you have 100 buttons, if you want to mention, so it is very difficult. So always test case should be short and meaningful. short and meaningful and simple. Then only we can say test case. Test case, it should be simple, meaningful, and simple and meaningful and short. Then only we can say test case. So check for the availability of the all the objects. Okay. So if I have 6 buttons, I can mention. But if you have 100 buttons, if you want to mention, it is very difficult. Like, you know, it not be short. So that means, so it is very difficult. That is the reason I gave, I separately, I maintained another table, that is login object tab. Yes, login object tab. Username, text box. Password, text box. Connect to combo box, login button, cancel button, and clear button. I mentioned everything. Button types also I mentioned. So I gave one name, that is login object tab. Right, come down. Valid input table. Correct username, correct password also I mentioned. So that is called valid input table. That is called valid input table. Correct username, correct password I am mentioning. So that is called valid input table. Valid input table. Next, invalid input table. Invalid input table. That means wrong username, wrong password I mentioned. If it is any application, so now we are working with the login application. So correct username, correct password, wrong username, wrong password I mentioned. So if it is correct username, correct password, I am mentioning valid input table. And if it is wrong username, wrong password, I am mentioning invalid input table. All right. Okay. Now you should tell, sir, just concentrate. First test case. Check for the availability of all the objects as per the login object tab. Customer is expecting all the objects must be available as per the login object tab. So expected value is means customer requirement. All the objects must be available as per the login object tab. Actual value, whatever we are getting, we will write in here. So all the objects are available as per the login object tab. So both are same. Expected value and actual value, both are same. We can give the status pass. Okay. Second one. Check for the consistency of the all the objects. Customer said all the objects must be available as per the consistent with each other. All the objects are consistent with each other. So both are same. Pass. GUI. Okay. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as GUI testing. Third one. Check for the spelling of the all the objects as per the login object tab. All the objects are must be spelled properly. All the objects are spelled properly. So both are same. We can give the status pass.
Okay.
Next one. Fourth one. Check for the initial position of the cursor. Check for the enabled property of login and clear and cancel buttons. Customer is said whenever invoke the login application, login clear must be disabled, cancel always enabled. So login clear and cancel are enabled, so fail. Expected value, actual value, both are not matched, so we can say fail.
Okay.
Fifth requirement, GUI, graphical user interface. We are not performing any actions on the application. We can see and we can say, check for the initial position of the cursor. Initially, the cursor must be positioned in the username field. Initially, the cursor is present in the username field. So both are same. We can give the status pass.
Okay.
Fifth requirement, positive testing, positive. Enter some information into any username field and password field and check for the enabled property of login button. After entering username and password, login button must be enabled. That is the customer requirement. Login button is enabled. So same. Both are same. So expected value, actual value, both are same. So result is pass. Next. Enter some information into any of the fields and check for the enabled property of clear button. Already customer said, so after entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. So clear button must be enabled. Clear button is enabled. So same, pass.
Yeah.
Eighth one. Enter username and password and check for the valid input table. VIT means valid input table and click on login button. After entering username, valid username, password means correct username, correct password. If you click on login button, corresponding page must be displayed. Corresponding page is displayed as per the login object table. So pass. Enter username and password as per the valid input table and select a database option, click on login button. So what will happen? Corresponding page must be displayed. Corresponding page is displayed. So pass. 10th. Enter username. Enter some information into any of the field and click on clear button. What will happen? All the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. All the fields are cleared, cursor not placed in the username field. So fail.
Fail. Okay.
God. Eleventh one. Positive test case. Click on the cancel button. Application must be closed. That is the customer requirement. Application is closed. So pass. Both are same. Pass. 11th one is pass. 12th one. Check for the tabbing order of the application. Already customer said the tabbing order of the application, username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. So username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel buttons. Both are same. We can give the status pass. Enter username, password as for the invalid input table. That means wrong username, wrong password. If you click on login button, what will happen? Corresponding error message must be displayed. Corresponding message not displayed. So fail.
Okay.
Enter username and password. Enter some information into any of the field and check for the enabled property of login button. Already customer is said after entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. But here is login button is enabled. So fail.
Okay.
Enter only password. Only is entering only password. If you click on login button, what will happen? Login button must be disabled. Login button is enabled. So fail. So this is the concept, test cases concept. Okay.